also host meetings, seminars, and symposiums. And I'll show you. This initiative will be hosted at 5 level in Brazil. It's a laboratory from the 5 festival. Well, I'm just putting some information about what is the FIO. FIO is an electronic festival that we have in Brazil. It's one of the most important electronic art festivals and also symposiums that we have in São Paulo every year for 10 years now. And we have now the different cities and other people are attending. And this year we are expecting 200,000 people to attend the festival. In 3 cities, major cities, Porto Alegre, Rio de Janeiro, and São Paulo. And well, this laboratory that we decided to open, I am one of the founders of this lab in São Paulo, and the FIO lab. When we created it, we have a mission for this laboratory. And the idea is the development of research and experimentation of multidisciplinary works in the field of new media, open source, performance, and art and technology. It offers an environment, the laboratory offers an environment of multidisciplinary researchers and creators in a platform of free collaboration among national and international artists. FIO Labs infrastructure was designed to hold projects in art and technology. It has, as a name, the cultural and technological exchange, offering residences and interchange among national and international communities, inserting its production into a globalized context of research and development compatible with the contemporary software studies mentality. Well, we are planning to open this laboratory, the software studies there, on August 7th, 2008 of this year. We are planning monthly meetings there in São Paulo in this laboratory. We have a space. We have 2 pictures of the laboratory. We have a space, computers, and wood infrastructure that we got from some institution in Brazil. And also, we are planning to have a biennial workshop there. Maybe I hope that all of you can attend this workshop too in Brazil, and I think that you're going to enjoy São Paulo. It's a little bit chaotic, but you can go. And we are going to have this opening, and the idea is have the host teleconferences there in this laboratory with a group of people that are going to be there developing research and fellowships that we are planning to. The objectives of the software studies in Brazil is the development of researches and features of software to analyze the impact of the culture of the software in Brazil, not only in Brazil, but basically in Latin America. Also, we are planning to do something like this with friends from Argentina and Uruguay and Paraguay, 2 small countries. Also, create a network of software studies in Brazil with academic institutions, research centers, and research governmental agencies such as this CAPES and CNPq and FENEPTRN. These are agencies supported by the Ministry of Science and Technology, Ministry of Education, and Ministry of Culture that we have in Brazil. They have grants and money that you can raise to support these studies. Also, we are working on trying to get some funds to support some fellowships. And we already have 5 fellowships and housing in Brazil for artists, and we are going to try to get some now fellowships for so the software studies group to in Brazil, and then people can apply and develop some research there on this field. Well, now I'm going to talk about briefly about the projects that we are going to start there. This project is called Meta Browser. It's a project that I'm developing since almost 2 years. It's a kind of software to visualize information on the internet. It's being supervised by Ted Nelson, and I'm developing part of it. It's a kind of browser and also a server. I'm going to show you. It's just an image. It's not working yet. We are developing. It's going to be a kind of API or something for a browser. This project has been developed. It's a kind of visualization and a server, and it's based on Ted Nelson's Zigzag project. Okay, and then it is finished and the software study initiative in São Paulo. Okay. And then you can see it's a browser and a lot of screens. And, you know, we have some tests doing programming this in Java and the other image in the API. Okay. And the other project that we are going to start in Brazil is going to be a cultural analysis of the open source in Brazil. Okay. We have a lot of things being developed in Brazil, and I'm going to show you, for example, the Brazilian government nowadays, they are using the open source tools to administrate and develop its systems. Okay, and I'm going to show you here. The website of the Ministry of Culture of Brazil. Creative Commons, and Brazil has a strong partnership with some law schools and professors of law, you know, and nowadays they are this professor of law school in Brazil, they are lecturing for judges of the Supreme Court of Rio de Janeiro about the copyright laws and how Creative Commons can be a tool for new model for copyrights. And also the Minister of Culture, the Gilberto Gil, has a strong agenda towards the Creative Commons regulation of the Brazilian cultural and artistic copyrights.